Back today with the LaserPecker LP4. It's a nice little laser. I just want to show you a few more things with it that I didn't get to in my last video. Today I have the slide extension set up. We're not going to use it right now for this, but we will use it. And then we're also going to take a look at the rotary tool. I actually need to go run to the store and buy some bottles that'll fit because we threw away a bunch of reusable bottles and the only ones we have are ginormous. They're like, you know, this big, so they won't fit in the tool. So I'll go get some of those and we'll check that out too. But right now, I do have the extension tool set up here. It's really easy to assemble. The base comes assembled. You then put this plate on with three screws, this plate on with three screws, then you plug it in and you're good to go. You do have this extension tool too, which helps bring out the laser's area because you're losing some height here, so it raises it that amount of height and then brings it out so you're more centered on the plate here. So I've got a little file set up here. We are using the software on the computer. I apologize for the glare, but you can do the app or you can use their software. Their software is actually not that bad. I was going to hook it up to Lightburn, but this is more than adequate for like 95 to 99% of what people are going to be doing. So you can set that up. You either use the USB cable or it comes with, at least mine came with a Bluetooth dongle. So you can use a Bluetooth dongle. I mean, it's completely fine here for me to use it because it's right there. So we're going to do the slate coaster real quick. So I'm going to select slate in the material. We're going to just go ahead and use the presets to see what they're like. I know you can't really read this, but over here you have your lasers, you have the resolution you want to use, you have a material with some presets, passes and powers, depths, speed, all of that stuff. It's pretty simple. So I'm just going to do a preview to make sure I am lined up. I still am. That's about where I want it because of the defects in the material. And then we're going to go ahead and go to next. It's asking us to confirm the settings. Confirm. And here we go. So while that's going, it's at about 7% already. It's going to speed up here. I really like this thing. It's nice. It's much nicer than the competition one I had. Well, the competing one that I actually bought, what, about a year ago now, it looked nice. It was slick, but it was a piece of junk. This thing, everything I'm throwing at it is great. And their software is a little bit better. Their app's a little bit better. At least it was when I tried the competitor's app. It's better than that. It did already have a firmware update when I took it out of the box. So they're actually updating the equipment, which is nice to know because there is a newer version of this out, the LP5. This is the LP4. They have all of them for sale still, I think. So, you know, they're clearly still supporting them. Let's go back to this real quick. You can see it's just knocking that off. What I would recommend is if you're doing this, do it outside if you can. Obviously you could do it inside, just make sure you have a lot of ventilation. You don't necessarily want to breathe the dust and stuff from this. So here it is going, and I would just say that if you're going to do this a lot, I would do it outside or make sure you have the cone on and the air filtration going. You don't necessarily want to breathe the stuff that's being lased off of there, whatever the word is. Ideally, I do this stuff outside, but it's still dark out, and I just wanted to knock this out because I got a lot of yard work to get to today. I'm sure you understand. But yeah, I like this thing. I never got results this good with the competing laser on these slate coasters, even after experimenting a ton, and this one's just going for it. Like, this is the default setting. It looks fantastic. To do this quality previously, I would have to use, like, laser marking spray or a sealer. I would put a spray clear sealer on and then you would laze it and then it would kind of get like this, but it would still look burnt, for lack of a better word. But this is coming out amazing. I wasted so much time with that other one. Like, I really like this thing. They've got a nice little product here. But I'm gonna let this wrap up and then we'll take a look at it when it's done. It is done, so let's go ahead and get this off. Take a look at it. You can see that, you know, that's on there pretty good. Now, you could take images, graphics, words, you know, whatever, SVG files, pictures, and just throw them on here, experiment a little. The default slate setting worked beautifully. I think it's called Slate Slab in the drop-down menu. But yeah, I'm really satisfied with that. That is great. I have a bunch of these coasters. I want to play around with this a bunch now. I finally have something to use them on. So yeah, let's get something else out and take a look at that. I've got the bottle and the rotary tool here. It's a little oddly shaped, so it's less than optimal because it kind of, you know, flanges up at the top, but this is the bottle I could find. To assemble this is pretty easy. You slide this onto the plate, you lock it. You put a couple screws into the plate for that. I think it's four. And then you attach these jaws. There's two kinds of jaws. There's three-step jaws that look like a little pyramid thing. And then there's these bigger ones. You just put two screws for each of them. There's three in total. And you put them on. And that's it. There's also these little, like, needle-looking things that you can attach instead to, like, hold stuff from the inside, say, a ring or something. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and give this a try here. I've already got it in the preview mode. You can kind of see that. And then we're going to click next. You can see it in action there. Just putting my little skull and crossbones on. And there you have it. I did put the logo upside down in the software. That's my bad. Be aware of that when you are doing this. But yeah, I'm gonna try to... I've moved the design down and shrunk it a ton. I just wanna do it again real quick. That one I did at 1K, so you can kind of see the lines. Doing it at 8K now. It'll take a little bit longer if it was the same size, but since I shrunk it a bunch, it should go about the same speed. Let's find out. So, got my preview. I've reoriented the direction. And I made it way too small, but you know, you learn. So here's a bit of a rookie mistake. Make sure that your lasing area is not gonna hit that jaw, because I'm just barely touching that jaw. So see here, we're done. Unfortunately, this bottle has a flat side and a round side. So we did transition over into that flat side a little. So be aware of your surfaces when you're doing this. But that came out a lot better than this one. There you can kind of see the texture. It's hard to see because of the light, but you can see those lines. That was done at 1K. This I did at 8K, and you don't see the lines unless you like really get up on it and look. But yeah, you can do this to, you know, water bottles and everything. And you could do this with glass with the rotary tool. You'll just want to take like a magic marker and give it something to actually hit, because it'll just pass through the glass. So when you put that black there, or laser marking spray, which is pretty expensive, there you go. Then you have that surface for glass. What I like to do is I just use dry erase marker, because then it wipes off real easy. But you could use permanent marker, anything that alcohol will remove, because once you're done coloring it, then you just wipe it with alcohol, and then you can see your design that you've done. But yeah, that's it. I really like this thing. I really, really do. That's the LaserPecker LP4. You can also do, you know, wood and plastic and some kinds of plastic. Be careful, make sure it's laser safe. Glass, you know, the slate, the metal business cards that are anodized, all kinds of stuff. You should be able to do like some stainless steel etching with this too. All kinds of fun stuff. But yeah, that's pretty much that. If you have any questions or comments or tips on how to do things better, leave those in the comment. There is a link in the sticky comment. There is a link in the description to this. And there is another video where I looked at some of the other features and settings of this thing. Overall, I love it. It's nice. It's compact. It goes back into the packaging well. All the styrofoam is cut nicely. Everything fits in. It's great. I love it. I will see you in the next video.